We out here in San Diego. Stopped three of the tours. Stopped three. We lit up Jamaica. We lit up New York. Now we out here in San Diego. New York was epic. It was epic. It was epic. It was epic. It was epic. Appreciate everybody who came out in New York. I can honestly say that was one of the most genuine trainings I've ever been a part of. Being in the room was an experience. Everybody who was in those rooms, I don't even know. I know you left with the information to take care of your business, but more importantly, take care of what you wrote down on the top of your paper. Take care of your why, the reason you're actually on this earth.
You're not listening to this information as a shy guy in the room.
But it was crazy, bro. From start to finish, it was crazy. I had like the chills watching all of the speakers.
Something that I'm chasing, I'm gonna be completely honest with you. I need everybody to write this down. Right? What I'm chasing is a lifestyle. But wait, I'm not chasing a lifestyle, right, to wear a Rolex. I'm not chasing a lifestyle to get on a jet. I'm chasing a lifestyle of getting every single day I'm on a non-candy.
And then just even presenting with the audience, it was amazing. I seen people who I grew up with from 6 years old up until people I met last week. And they're all family. And everybody had one common goal, which is to succeed and take care of, you know, the reasons they feel as if they're on this earth.
Get the drip like this. Icebox drip my wrist. Walk up in the club and I drip on a. You know I'm a P, I might pimp on a. Call them money, get the drip like this.
Drip like this, drip like this.
Call them money, get the drip like this.
Drip like this, drip like this.
Walk up in the club and I drip on a drip on a.
And that's what I'm loving about what we're doing now. Like, we're making money. We're trading. We're teaching people the skill. We're investing. But more importantly, people are really starting to connect to the greater good. Not even the greater good, but really starting to connect to why they're here. Alright, why their purpose, right? Their why, quote unquote. But it was sick, man. Rubens kicked us off. We kicked the event off like 6:20.
Accounts. Everybody's been through people falling out your business. But the only question is, are you gonna be somebody that fails and find ways to not fail again? It's somebody that fails and gives up. That's the true question you gotta ask yourself.
And what we did was, to open up the show, or the first half of the training, rather, I should say, we had all of the chairmen and chairwoman, shout out Keita, my shooter Keita, we had them all of them come up, and basically, they just gave gems, right? Ruben started us off, he talked about just sacrifice. I remember that specifically, he was talking about sacrifice, right? And thriving in solitude, all of the leaders talked about thriving in solitude, but Ruben specifically, he talked about sacrifice. And most people don't see the sacrifice for real in the hustle. Most people don't see the little things, like even here now, trying out these new things is a sacrifice. Being on the road, being without your loved ones, being out your family, right? It's just me and the shooter right now, me and Lloyd. So definitely I appreciated him talking about sacrifice because the people in New York definitely need to see that. The internet is allowing for people to come look at our business just where it's at versus what we've been through and the sacrifices we made. So he covered that. That was dope. And then after that, we had, who was next? Ja was next. Ja. Yo, Ja, shout out to you, bro. I love you, bro. If you ever see this, bro, I love you, bro. You're amazing, bro. He's a platinum producer. He's made beats for people such as the Migos, Designer, Casanova. For him to be in my family, just spreading love and teaching the people just his way, that was dope to me. That was extremely dope. One thing that stood out to me about Ja, he talked about paradigms. He talked about the shifting of your paradigm and how you kind of have to force yourself to do certain things. And over time, it'll naturally become who you are. And being that this year, I recently went to my first ever Bob Proctor conference, and I watched him speak. So I've seen him twice this year. I'm starting to get familiar with that talk. So to watch him talk about that to the people in New York, that was dope to me. I know that probably went over a lot of people's heads, but Ja, I love you for that, and that touched me again. I know what was going on, especially when you was talking that talk. But make sure you, bro, make sure you stay out, stay on beast mode, bro. The world needs to hear you, bro. You need to vocalize that, but you have such a powerful voice. No cap, bro. And a lot of people need to hear that, bro. That shit is amazing. That shit is amazing. After Ja, you had Rick came up. Rick is hilarious. Rick is hilarious, yeah. He came up, and I feel like he had a million thoughts going on in his head at once. But it was dope to see Rick up there, man, talking to his people. Especially a lot of them looking up to him, a lot of them relating to him. It was good for him to just go out there. And I feel like nowadays, like the past 3 months, we're getting the most transparent Rick ever. I feel like he's grown through a lot. He's learning, he's growing. And I'm excited, man. I'm excited to see what you turn into, bro. Just remember the teachings. Remember all your blessings, bro. Don't fuck around, blood. Right, but it was beautiful watching you go up there and speak, man. You got on the, I know you touched the people a little bit, got under their skin a little bit about really taking the opportunity seriously, making sure that they get results, making sure they do what they want to do, bro. And I appreciate you for that. I appreciate you for that. I can only imagine just like your next 6 months, your next 7 months, right? But remember to be as transparent with yourself as possible, bro, every day. Because you're killing it. I'm going to see you tomorrow in Houston, actually, but I'm going to see all my shooters in Houston tomorrow. After Rick, we had Imran come up.
A round of applause for everybody in this room, right? Everybody that's watching this. One thing that I want to kind of stress a little bit, and I'm being dead, dead serious when I say this, right? I'm really going to check. Raise your hand if you're a prophet. I'm checking, right? Everybody that raised your hand, I'm really checking. You a prophet?
Yeah.
Can I see?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Raise your hand if you're a prophet again. Just seriously. I'm checking. It's a lot less hands raised. I'm being so serious. I'm not gonna laugh right now. Alright? I'm being so serious, man.
Different, bro. Different, bro. I wish I had my notebook. I left my notebook in New York. If you were in that vicinity, or if you're in the venue rather, and you just took my notebook, just mail it to me, bro. That's my little notebook that I use on the road. But I took a lot of powerful notes from you yesterday, Imran. And one thing you talked to me about that I like, bro, you're chasing a lifestyle now. And most people, when they hear that, they're like, okay, he's chasing a lifestyle. Even me, when I first heard it, for the first split second, I won't lie to you. I know everybody felt like that. It's like, oh, you're chasing a lifestyle, the cars, the money, the expensive stuff, the flashy, the materialistic. But then you hit us all, you were like, nah, I'm chasing the lifestyle of the trainings. I'm chasing the lifestyle of the hustle. You're chasing the lifestyle that created the lifestyle, bro. And that was powerful, bro. That was powerful, bro. I could tell you're studying the GOATs.
Okay. Okay. Right now, you gotta understand now that you cannot build your way to Jimmy, bro. You cannot build your way to Jimmy. You have to result your way to Jimmy.
And I can tell you, you're taking it very seriously, bro. C500 your body this year, bro, no cap. That was powerful for me to see you in there talking like that, doing your thing. Especially because you know your journey, bro, you know your story. So for you to be out in New York doing what you did yesterday at Chairman 10, call me on, good Rolly, right? And then for you to really dig deeper, though, and tell the world that you're chasing the lifestyle, that provide the lifestyle, bro, that really touched me, bro.
Truly, but you gotta understand that we're in an opportunity, right? For money, when I was just having a conversation earlier, money should never be an issue when you join this opportunity. And it's not to say that everybody doesn't go through real life stuff, being completely honest. But we have a gateway to a $7.3 trillion market.
That really, really touched me. No cap, blood. After that, we had Cheetah. Cheetah, I love you, sis. I love you so much.
A lot of people on campus were saying, no, I think Trade House Investment Group is only for men. I think it's a guys group. Do you remember that, Nate? Like, you wouldn't know. But everybody on the outskirts were literally trying to say that it's only for men. And I was like, get out of here. Like, yeah, I'm about to get in this and show what's up.
It's crazy because the way you was edifying me yesterday and talking about me is like, I always, when I hear you speak and I hear you tell a story, it always brings me back because you were dead ass in my corner when nobody was, well, not nobody, I should say, but when a lot of people was outside of my gang, outside of the core, right? You know my gang, right? You know my chairman friends, my chairman brothers, my line brothers. Outside of them, there wasn't necessarily anybody who seen and supported the vision. And especially as a young lady, right? In a society, not even a society though, but the vicinity that we were in at the time, for you to be who you were, such a prominent figure in the AUC and to believe in us and to believe in me specifically, like that shit meant a lot. So when you tell a story, I always get the chills and I like it gets me emotional, bro, because that shit meant a lot.
Once I joined you guys, it was one of those, I was just thinking about money, 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 okay, let's get back, right? And as well, it's like, okay, we're thinking about getting the bag and when it comes to trading in the foreign exchange market, but as well, I'm thinking about the bag when it comes to the building aspect, right? I come in my first like, month and a half, I, you know, go pieces hundred.
But you coming to my hood, you coming to New York, and you talking to the woman if that was different. Because I know you touched them in a way that I could never touch them. Just woman to woman is something about a young lady seeing another successful young lady. Same way like a gentleman. He sees a gentleman with his fly chains on, with his fly fit, you get inspired. But I personally feel like from women to women, especially in this business, it's like the biggest impact. Like for you to come to my neck of the woods, right, New York, and just pour into my people, and you didn't necessarily have to, that meant a lot to me. But your training was amazing. Your training was amazing. You're just very transparent, even as a young lady making six figures, right, on your way to make it eight figures this year. It's crazy. But you was extremely transparent about how it's always a journey, it's always an experience, no matter where you're at with it. So I appreciated that a lot, Keita. I love you so much. I love you so, so much. All right, number one shooter in the world, come on, Keita Jackson, man. Chairwoman 500, her body is coming soon. In progression on, we had Chairman Dan.
I'm gonna tell you what I've been enforcing my specific team to do, and I'm gonna share it with the family because we're all family here, right? And I did not get this from me. I did not get this from me, right? I got this from an educator, right? If everybody has an active package, you have access to these educators, right? His name goes by Tika Blue. He said, bro, I'll never forget, it was iMillennials 1. I'm like, bro, I'm not gonna lie, you're telling me you're making thousands of dollars a day, right? I'm following the 10% rule, I'm doing this and that third, I'm still feeling like I'm not making enough money. He's like, bro, 50 pips a day. Write that down. 50 pips a day. I'm like, bro, 50 pips a day, that's nothing. He's like, bro, 50 pips a day at a lot size that you feel like can make you enough money. Right? So I'm like, all right, let me actually listen. Right? Nate says it all the time, listen and apply, right? Let me actually listen to somebody who has a success. Family, I can't remember the last time I blew an account.
Chairman Dan, bro, you touched me. You was on your David and Monita vibes, C500 vibes. You start to speak about the word. And you said a specific Bible verse.
Philippians 4:13. Whoever knows that verse in the Bible, somebody scream it out right now. Say it again. Perfect. You have to have a big amount of faith in this business, right? Because there's going to be times where you feel like you cannot do it. Give me a raise of hands if you felt at times you cannot succeed in this business. Let's be transparent, right? I was at that point as well. Keita, Nate, Reed, Rick, Rubens, right? We were all there, right? But at the same time, we realized, okay, it is vision over sight.
That touched me. I remember I was going to the bathroom and I listened to it before I went in. And you said something along the lines of, through Christ, I can do all things. And it just touched me, bro, because it's like one of the first times I ever heard you speak with the word. And I remember my first time speaking with the word, how you told me how it impacted you. And to see you duplicating it and pouring it back into your people, that meant a lot. That meant a lot, because I know it touched everybody in the room. And then just seeing you up there speaking, bro, like you're really on your Chairman 500 vibes, bro. You've been there since P150 days. You've been there when I was P600, you're Planet 150. So it meant a lot for me to see you up there in your element, also on your suede palmy and your Balenciaga Triple S. All that meant a lot. But you're speaking with such power nowadays, and I know you're inspiring a lot of people. You inspired me yesterday.
We're gonna demand it from the universe, right? We're gonna demand it from the universe. And I'm not gonna do a traditional chairman scream. I'm not gonna do a regular chairman scream, right? We're gonna blow the roof off this thing.
You know what I mean? So that was big. That was big. And then after that, I pretty much just blacked out. I went in my bag. Just got in my bag.
I'm feeling good. Everybody, can I get a... I am successful.
I am successful.
I am God's highest form of creation.
I am God's highest form of creation.
I am a trillionaire.
I am a trillionaire.
I'm a beast. My family is going to be free.
My family is going to be free.
No, for real, like, my family is going to be free.
My family is going to be free.
Need somebody to scream that. My family is going to be free. That's good stuff. All right, let's get one more loose and out, everybody. Woo!
I really just wanted people to win. I wanted my people to win. And obviously I'm from New York. I love talking in New York. I'm gonna be a little bit more transparent in New York. That's really what happened. I really want 400-600 chairman, chairwoman out of New York through this opportunity. I really want 300-600 people who gained success through this opportunity and learn this skill from New York. I don't even want it to stem back from Nathan Samuel. I don't care about the credit. I really just want you guys to win.
This information, when we come back, we're going to be back here on the 31st, and it's done strategically. When we come back and we go through this information, I'm going to say, okay, what's step two to the blueprint? And everybody should say it. Boom.
Because I understand how it feels to be coming from the concrete jungle, coming from the island, man. Shout out to island. I understand how it feels to not have heat some days. I understand how it feels to parents don't come home some days. I understand how it feels to grow up in a single parent household sometimes. I understand how it feels to be in those environments where it's a little bit more aggressive. So I take it very seriously when I'm in New York and I'm talking to my family because I want you guys to win. So I blacked out and I just spoke from my heart. I spoke from my heart. I don't even try to speak from my mind anymore in trainings because I speak from my heart. Because it's obvious, it's as clear as day, the products work. IAM is the best company in the world. So it's clear as day, the products work. But it's not always clear as day if we work, if Nathan works. So I definitely want to speak from my heart to make sure everybody know that all you have to do is try. You have the ability to be just as successful as anybody else. You have the ability to go to Jamaica, New York, California, and Houston in the same week. So you can spread love all over with your people, with your family. Everybody's time is coming. It's already done. It's already happening. So New York, I just made sure y'all felt me. I wanted to make sure y'all were loved. I mean, y'all knew y'all were loved, right? I wanted to make sure y'all knew that y'all have somebody who is going to be there no matter what.
It is designed for you to win. Launchpad, in general, Trade House is designed for you to win. So there are going to be trainings offered you every single day where you can win. Am I making my money work for me? That's the main thing I want you to worry about as it pertains to these products if you're going to worry at all. I didn't tell you to worry about anything else today, but I told you if you're going to worry about anything, I'm worried about if your money is going to work for you with these products. Right? How many of us can agree about worrying about making our money work for us? Right? Good stuff.
And I said it in the training, man. My biggest priority now, my why, right, is your success, is my family's success. And I'm a firm believer that not everybody, but there's a lot of people, just because of how seriously I take this position, how seriously I take my responsibility, I may be more dedicated to your success than you are. That's not a big deal because I remember times where people were more dedicated to my success than I was. Shit, currently right now, there's people more dedicated to my success than I am just because they've been through certain things and they want to make sure I'm matriculated and go through the same things. So it's just a beautiful thing to be out here in California, the sun hitting me, and for me to just reflect on this fam, man. Shout out Lloyd, man, with me every step of the way, my brother. Shit's crazy, bro. Because you never really expect When you're coming into it, you want to make money, you want to make a bag, but you never really expect it. I never really expected to fall in love with it this way, to fall in love with the people, to fall in love with my family, to fall in love with their success. You asked me 3 years ago that I work for somebody else's success 24/7. I look at you like you're fucking crazy. But now it's like, it's exactly what I do. That's exactly what I'm probably gonna do. It's exactly what I will do until the day, you know. The Lord sees us not fit here anymore. But I love y'all, man. I love y'all, New York. I salute y'all. I know big things are coming. I know big, big things are coming, man. Took some dope flicks, took some dope content. And I'm just ready to write up the rest of the tour, man. San Diego tomorrow. Be ready. Houston's Friday and Saturday. I'm gonna use two. Be ready. We working, man. We working. I've realized it's not about no money. It's not about the money. It's not about your pockets. It's not about my pockets. It's about the love right now. The love, the impact, making sure other people are successful, making sure other people are winning, making sure that we're self-educated, we're self-loved, right? Right, making sure that we know that we're beautiful, man, we're the best. That's really what I'm out here for. And you might, it's crazy, you might never hear this from me. You might never hear this from me if you don't watch this video. You might not never hear this if you see me walking around. You might see me in a club looking lit, whatever, ice out. But you might never really hear this, but I always feel like it's just good to express yourself truly, how you feel, at least once. And this is my one time, because after this, I'm back in the field, man. C500 run, I got to get all my guys C500. I'm actually talking to my guys right now. That's why I actually have 3 phones now. All right, but I love all my guys, man. And transparently enough, I feel like I don't tell you guys I love you enough. I love everybody. I'm not perfect, but hey, we're making this shit work. I'm helping a lot of people along the way. Sweating at events, man. I'm sweating at all my events now. But I want you to understand, I left it all out there. It's like I'm going to the gym. It's the same thing as I'm going to an event. I'm just talking from my heart. I'm leaving it all out there, and I'm not stopping. I'm not stopping until it's all out. So New York, that's what you got yesterday. All roads lead to London tour. So that everybody's going to get. Right, Jamaica, I love you all, Jamaica. I love you all, Jamaica. It's unfortunate. The shooter, he was in recovery when we were in London, so it's all right. I mean, excuse me, when we were in Jamaica, so it's all right.
Events in 3 different countries in the next months. We're blessed that the first stop is to be in Jamaica. We actually all have roots from Jamaica, so this one is like a little bit more personal to us, right? But this is our village. That is our village, so I know how this feels, and I know what comes with this life, and I know the lifestyle that comes with this life, and I truly want everybody to feel that feeling.
What? Jamaica, we lit it up, man. Shout out Omari, shout out Mari, shout out RJ. Shout out Mom Dukes, right? Omari's mom. You guys took great care of us. I love you guys all. And if you ever see this, which I hope and pray you will, just don't forget to be successful. Don't forget to kill it. Don't forget to work at it daily. You guys are going to do some powerful things in Jamaica. I guarantee it. I told you that, Omari. You're going to do some powerful, powerful things. But we have to make sure to commit to our 980 hours, our 980 days. I'm going to be on tour saying that in every stop, man. Make sure we commit to our 980 hours and 980 days. We got 980 days. Because we commit ourselves to this opportunity for 980 days, I firmly believe, like, we will start to create the rest of forever for us. Not only for us, but for our families as well. You see now, my family's growing now. About to have 20,000 family members, so it's working, man. Shout out all the guys. Shout out Bryce Thompson. Shout out Brandon Thompson. Shout out Ray Rice. I love you. Shout out Joshua Stewart. I love you. Thompsons, y'all know I love y'all. Shout out all the guys, man. Shout out Keita. Shout out Vic, shout out Josh, shout out Rubens, shout out Iman, shout out Ant. See a lot more shooters, I don't want to forget anybody. Shout out Rubens, shout out Chip and Dan, shout out Rick. Shout out all the guys, man. All the guys. Shout out my Detroit shooters. All right, but we out in San Diego right now. We vibing, got the palm trees around me, probably about to take some flicks. That's how you're gonna roll, man. A lot of real content, just a lot of talking, a lot of just being transparent. Because I really fell in love with it, and I want people to fall in love with it the way I do. I want people to fall in love with putting somebody else's success before your own. So for that reason, you're gonna cancel everything you have for the next 60 days. Sorry, family, I can't go there. I can't do this. 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 Because I have to tend to my family. I have to tend to their needs. I have to tend to their success stories. I really love this shit, though. Shout out to all the guys, man. Shout out Chris Terry, Alex Morin, David Amonitier, Matt Rosa, Jason Brown, Isis De La Torre. Everybody, man. Love y'all.
Yeah, yeah, look, gang, gang, whoa, gang, gang, whoa, look, hey, hold on, let me get on my shit, look, better take a flick, this the last time you can see me like this, look, I'm switching the sits, I got some plans, the ice on my wrist,
Story every city with it, man, San Diego with it, you know, last night.
Better take a flick. This the last time you can see me like this. Look, I'm switching the sitch. I got some places to ice on my wrist. And I ain't flipping no bricks. I need some inches to pass on my kids. This shit is real as it gets.
We out Florida right now. Orlando. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. It feels like we've been all around the world. And lately the past month, but we here. We back at it again. I'm working. I'm about to set up Virgin Islands right now as we speak. But all roads tour, man, it's been amazing. It's been amazing. It's been amazing. The last check-in, we checked in, we were in San Diego. We had just smashed Jamaica and New York. And like we said, those events was amazing. It was amazing. So, yeah, fast forward. Then next on the stop three on the old roads tour, we did San Diego. And San Diego was dope.
Right? And I'm gonna go into the steps how to be a profitable trader, but the reason I'm starting off with this, because if you kind of look at this, this is all kind of like ties into just mindset, right? If you want to win, you gotta have a winning mindset. You can't come into this opportunity and say, hey, okay, this trade's gonna hit stop loss. It's gonna hit stop loss if you think like that, right? Oh, no one's gonna join my business this month. No one's gonna join your business like that. You know, your words are powerful. You're literally speaking things into existence, right? So I just wanted to go into a quick little mindset before we get to the technical stuff.
It was really, really dope. It was me and Dan outside, just a two-man weave in San Diego, me, Dan, and the shooter. And it was dope. It was a classroom environment. And being that I'm a college student, it always like, it's like full circle moments for me when I'm in front of the classroom teaching, doing whatever it is we do. But it was dope. It was, Dan opened up, Dan started to talk about just plugging. He started to talk about plug and talk. He started to talk about what you need in order to be successful.
Right. Obviously the 10% rule for that is 0.10. But now let's just say a USD JPY sell. Right. The most you want to put in for that first entry, that first initial entry, is a 0.05. At the most. But what you got to realize is you have 10 cents to play with. So one thing I learned with trading, the trading plan is you want to diversify your trades. You want to put as much, because multiple trades will be sent throughout the day via new Launchpad channel.
It's crazy on these specific events. Each and every chairman individually, they told you what you needed to become successful, especially if you attended. I want you to take note to that.
But now you guys all said you have active platinum packages, right? Family, use what you pay for. Use what you pay for. You pay $225, we're paying $164 for a reason, right? But now the products that they're giving us within that package is going to help us become even more profitable. And you have to understand, instead of taking that route, like I said, being that master trader, you're already getting these trade ideas and these profitable trades from educators, from 6- and 7-figure educators.
You didn't necessarily need to hear the information from 4 or 5 different people, but we set it up like that so you can get 4 or 5 different perspectives and then you could kind of relate to what you could relate to. But we jumped out the gates like that in San Diego, and Dan just basically gave the people, our people, the blueprint of what it takes to be successful. And I love San Diego because it was a smaller event. It was about 15 to 20 people. And in those type of events, you could be a little bit more transparent and you could kind of feel the vibes. You could feel the success. You could feel the hunger.
I just want to help as much people become
pertains to like the reason you what your why is, right? And once that happens to you, I firmly believe, okay, that's what really starts to set people free. People start to live more comfortable, right? So I've established my why now, and it wasn't always like that, I'll be honest. Like, I joined this opportunity to make money. I joined this opportunity because I wanted to bang, I wanted to flex, things like that. But along this journey, the transition house now, it's really been like, okay, I really am attached to other people's success. And I've been saying it all over the place, but like, I pride myself on now that I try to put myself in a position, or I do put myself in a position where I take someone's success more seriously than they do. Right? It's not because I'm better, it's just they might not see their success as clear as I do, or they might take this opportunity specifically, or take the opportunity that I've done, right, to get to their why, and I'm able to just help them get there that much more smoothly. Right? So it's my job to take it seriously. If I take it more seriously than you, then you'll get quicker results, you'll be able to live your life, right? And then there, that's why I feel like once that point is reached, then we'll really have massive success.
So it was dope to see that, and there was like a lot of minorities in the room. So I felt like I felt like we was in New York, we was in Long Island talking to our people. But we're literally across the country. So yeah, San Diego was dope. Dan set it off, he did his thing, murdered it. And then I came back around and I basically murdered it too.
These chats are gonna provide you a lot of trainings just like what I'm doing right now. And they might not be from me, but they might be someone who listened to information from Lincoln Samuel, listen to information from Chairman Dan or from another chairman or somebody else who kind of understands this information. And you guys gotta realize, like, okay, this is $1 million information, right? Although we may be in the library, it might seem like, all right, we're in the field, we're in the trenches. A lot of us have similar upbringings, and that's why I love being in this position, talking to the family. But at the end of the day, we can't just be humble when Chairman 100 is speaking in front of us. We also have to be humble when we're in the Launchpad chat. And like I said, there's these people, 50s, these P600s, hosting these trainings for us to get on. So every single day, right? Every single day, you want to apply this word to, okay, your educational process. I'm going to talk about one of the steps, but literally in all things that you do, and this opportunity specifically, right, you want to have that humble mindset, okay, this is for myself, this is for my why, this is for what's at the top of my paper, right? In all things that you do, in all things that you do, and I can't stress that enough. And I use that analogy from the trainings because you're going to get a lot of trainings. You're going to get a lot of trainings, right? Trainings is actually where the success starts.
I talked about just plugging in. I gave the blueprint. I gave some transparent conversation, and I just let the people know that I'm here for them. In every city, I'm letting the people know I'm here for them. And even on, from my perspective, on my side, it's beautiful to go on tour and go into the inner cities, meet the people, meet the family, because it's growing big. It's growing pretty, pretty big. And just seeing the family from all over the country, all over the world, and just hearing their stories and realizing that they have an opportunity to take care of their success and their why the same way I did, it's beautiful. So I love the fact that we got out there, and that's what we did in San Diego. There's nothing really to talk about. It was me and Dan, Bron and Wade, Shaq and Kobe, whatever you want to call it. We came through, we lit it up, and we dipped. The event was about 2 hours, and yeah, that was that.
How many of us have ever left $30 somewhere, came back in a month, and it was $300? Now you have a vehicle where you can do that, but the last thing you need to do is stick that. This is the one thing I hate. How many of us have put $30 down, left our $30, looked at somebody else put down $500, watch them walk away, grow their account, and then come back to our $30 because theirs grew, we think ours is gonna grow. Has that ever happened in life, ever? Have you ever watched somebody's money work for them and you watch what they're doing, copying and pasting, so now you're coming back to your $30 and you're trying to take those same exact rules that they've made over there and put it back on your money. To this account, you follow the same information. And the beautiful thing is, like, that's 90 days. That's 90 days. That also means, okay, that's 90 days worth of trainings. So as you're growing your money, you're like reminding yourself every day of how you're growing your money, how you're growing your business. And this is just one side, because you're also going chairman every single day. And so you'll have your team builders, you'll have your IBOs to constantly remind you. But you also know that you result you with the chairman.
Right now is this moment and this week.
Yeah, that's today. I like that. That's today. Let me see the week. Yeah. That's from plugging in?
Yeah, plugging in.
That's dope.
That's
live?
Yeah.
Can we get a zoom in on him, Lloyd?
After the San Diego, we flew to our millennials too.
How many people we dealt in our business They come and join our business, right? They get all this education, they know how to use the tools, they finally get their strategy going, and then they leave the organization and they try to go through their own thing. Right? We got those expert traders, right? We know them, right? We know them all.
Yo, I'm millennials too. January 10th and 11th, those days would go down in history. Shout out to you, Bryce Thompson. Real GOAT. I love you, bro. I love you. It's crazy. The other day, I was going through some crazy stuff, and you texted me, you love me, bro. That shit meant the world to me. You don't even know that. But, yeah, shout out to you, bro. I love you. You did some amazing shit January 10th and 11th. Felt as if I was one of the first moments where you made sure the world seen what we've been doing for the past 3 years. And you did that. I didn't do that. Brandon, Bryce, Stu, none of us did that. But you know what I mean. Like Brandon, Ray, Stu, Ian, of course, we're all a beautiful family. But Bryce, you did that. And I'm millennials too. And I'm proud of you for that. I'm extremely proud of you. And I'm grateful to have you in my corner as a brother. You like my shirt? Yeah, but I'm millennials too. Yo, we lifted up. We lifted them. Day one was amazing. Day one was kind of like your trading day. You had Teacup Lou come out.
Hey, how many of you guys are really all in with this? Be honest. Listen. You can lie to people. When you go home, you can't lie to that mirror.
Shout out to you, Lou. I love you, big bro. You had Lazardo again. You had Go Cup, Long Money Luke come out. I love you too, Long Money Luke. Shout out to you.
I'm Iron Academy, IML previously. And that's where I started my journey for about 5 months in, is my entrepreneurship. You know, network marketing. And that's where I started learning about the different types of businesses that I have. And from that decision, right, I found a mentor, right, who you listen to, right? And I studied so much. I studied, right? I back tested. I mean, I still back test to this day. Last 2 days ago, I was on back testing for 6 hours. So my point is, you have to put in the work, right? This chart stuff, if you're on my sessions, like training is boring, right? It's just boring for me, right? Earlier, not this year, last year, about February, March, I got a little depressed, right? And I was making really, really good money. Why? Because I hit all my goals. I retired myself, I retired my wife, I retired my mom. What now? Right? So you have to find out why. The deep why that where you what that has to be more than money. Right? It has to be something so deep within inside of yourself, right, that you're going to have it's for your kids, your family, your parents, whoever, because it's easy to put on yourself, but it's harder to put on your kids.
We had Starboy come out. Shout out to you. I love you, Starboy. Gustavo coming out.
Let's have a conversation about this man. Because like I always say, risk management is if you know how to manage your money, right? If you know how to manage 1,000, you can manage 10,000. If you can manage 10,000, you can manage 100,000. So whoever you are, if you know you're still having a hard time trying to manage even $100, right? I want you to understand you're a risk factor. Risk what you have, not what you don't have.
A whole bunch of beautiful education on that very first day, that Friday. And that was That was dope to me. Y'all know I love education, especially in this opportunity. I like to see the people win and like them to be educated so they can truly pass results. So that very first day, that's exactly what the people got. And then as well, we got Christopher Terry came in on the first day, gave some beautiful mindset gems. And he actually gave away $30,000 on stage. Chris Terry, if you ever see this, I love you, boss. I love you, boss, man. And continue to inspire me, continue to motivate me, and show me exactly what it is young kings and kings in general should be doing. But you gave away $30,000 on that stage, and two of those people were specific people I know who I call family, who I've invited to my house. So I know what that means to us, and I just want to let you know I love you for that. And I'm Millennials 2, day one. Bryce Thompson, you did that. You changed my life. Day two. Day two is interesting, man. Day two was crazy. It was crazy. We were in there suited, booted, tied up. So you can see the suits and tied. It's actually my first IM event, right? My first IM event, my first Trade House event on a major scale where I actually wore a tie. And it just provided a different perspective for me. I would always think I don't have to wear ties because, you know, I'm coming in there, no CEO. You know, people say ties are, what do people say about ties? They say it's like the worker's man's chain. It's like your shackles or whatever the case may be. But just growing up, dropped that perspective. And I came out there with my tie. My Ferragamo tie, Ferragamo loafs, yeah, tough suit, Ralph Lauren suit. It was amazing. Ray Rice had a suit and tie on too. He looked beastie. Joshua Stewart had a suit and tie on too. He looked beastie. Bryce Thompson had the little two-piece on, vest, slacks, big ice out. You know how we get, man. We had a whole bunch of different vibes out there, but ultimately, man, I know everybody left. I am too. With something.
He said, pick a mentor and use this word in something. Let it be duplication. Can y'all repeat that word after me? Duplication.
Duplication.
You gotta really think when your mom leaves the job and she's working at the job and she's doing something. Right? And then that was the goal. I told my mom, she got 30 days, so that building was over with. Right? My mom went to the middle.
Neuro meaning your brain, right?
Y'all understand, don't nobody care about what you're going through until you make something of yourself. You're not right. People talk about Tom Brady getting drafted in the sixth round. It don't matter if you got drafted in the sixth round until you win some championships. Hold all that stuff in real quick, go make some money, then tell everybody what's going on.
And to be generous right now on this stage, talking to you guys.
Let's go!
They can take not only, you know, the next 6 months, but for the rest of their life. And that's why I say you to go for that, Bryce Thompson. Even me. It's amazing watching all of the chairman speakers. I could go on and try to list everybody, but it's just too much to name. It was good to see Keita, Ja, Rubens, Ant, Vic. Just go at it, man. People were going at it. Ogay went at it. It was crazy. Jalen went at it. Ray Rice. Joshua Stewart, Brandon Thompson, Ian Jackson. Like I said, I don't want to forget anybody. A lot of people went at it that day. David Amelitier, Alex Morton, Christopher Terry. Ivan Tapia. It's literally just a blessing for me to be in that room, for me to be able to share the stage, for me to be able to introduce somebody to this opportunity and they share the stage with somebody like Ivan Tapia, somebody like Alex Moore, Christopher Terry, man. Do your research, look these people up. Multi-millionaires, speaking with people from my community, speaking with people who come from extreme levels of poverty. Imran Richie, you went on stage, you said we came from nothing. I really felt that. I'm proud of you too, Imran. Rick too, y'all did y'all thing, pick and roll. Shout out to the guys in Miami right now, going crazy. But yeah, I'm Millennials too. It was just that. I don't even have to talk. Just watch me light up the stage. Watch other champion leaders light up the stage.
You're grateful for the fact that you're in a position where you can better yourself around people who want you to win every single day, right? Every single
People left their heart in that event. I loved it, man. Bryce Thompson, you put your heart into it. So that's why everybody left their heart out. But yeah, man, that was dope. That was dope. That was dope. I'm millennials too. That taught me a lot. Told me a lot. It also told me to slow down on the turn up, man.
You're not in here to drink. You're coming in here to change the market. You came here because there's something deep down inside of you that you know you have to take care of.
Told me to slow down on the turn up, but just appreciate what you have going. And just appreciate the fact that you can grind 24/7. I never really appreciated the fact that, oh, I can wake up and grind. Sometimes it's like you have a really good day. Some crazy shit is just put in your face. And then the only thing you could do to get out of that crazy shit is just hustle and grind. So it was actually good for that to be in my face and for me to just be just reminded that you have the opportunity to grind 24/7. You have the opportunity to put your problems on the back burner and put somebody else's problems, right? Prioritize those first and get those done, and it'll make you feel that much better and make your problems feel that much more smaller. So I'm grateful for that. Thank you, God.
I don't think it's ever been done before. And it takes one person, and it takes another one person, and it takes another one person, and it takes a team.
But yeah, I'm letting us too. Were you there, bro? Make sure, especially, let me make this very clear right now, family, because I've seen this briefly at the I Am Millennials 2 event. And it's not a big deal, but because I always want 100% productivity, I want 100% of people to win, I felt like I should say this. When you attend these big events, you don't attend these big events because it's like a social hour, a social club, or for people to see your latest fashionable looks. You're actually attending these events to gain success and make sure that you take yourself to the next level and take your family to the next level through the information that is given to you, or whatever the case may be. But you have to make sure you're on the right end of that information. You have to make sure you're receiving that information. It kind of hit me a little bit. It hurt me a little bit just going taking my bathroom breaks while some of the leaders were speaking, and just seeing some people, you know, casually lounging around, casually talking. And I understand, you know, we're young. We like to enjoy life. We like to, you know, turn up, those type of things. But make sure you're taking your success extremely important, because no one is going to take it as important as you. And you're in full control of your time and what you do with your 24 hours. So if you're going to come out to these events, if your parents are going to send you out to these events, if you're going to go out here on behalf of your parents, because that's who you're obviously looking to work for, or you're looking to make sure, you know, they're taken care of throughout the success, make sure you take that 100% serious, man. It's not necessarily the time to get a Hennessy margarita. It's not necessarily the time to, you know, be talking with your friends. It's not necessarily the time to be setting up moves, because it's real life success going on. People are really pouring into you, and people have literally invested hundreds of thousands of dollars at this point for you to listen to that information. So make sure you take it serious, because I know I did, man. I'm millennials too. That was damn near one of my favorite events on tour thus far, and I feel like God is strategically setting up the events for us where each one is a stepping stone to the next one. We started off the event. We started off the tour outside of the country in Jamaica. And that just provided a lot of perspective moving forward with the Jamaica and New York, hometown New York. The people, more perspective. Then you went to San Diego, smaller crowd, 50 people across the country, but you could still relate. And then going to I'm Millennials 2, where it's like, oh my God, 3,000-4,000 people? It's 4,000 people at that event. It's amazing what we have going on. It's amazing. I'm just blessed and honored to just even be sitting here in front of these cameras, man, talking my shit. Guys, I vividly remember the times where blase, blase, blase. You don't got to talk about it. You know the story. Rags to riches. Everybody talks about it. Everybody has their rags to riches moment. But make sure you keep hustling so you can have yours, man. And that's exactly what this tour is about, making sure everybody has their moment in the future. Everybody has the correct information to have their moment in the future. All right? After that, fast forward, I'm millennials. We shot out of Houston. We flew to Atlanta. Right? Atlanta was the next stop on the tour. Atlanta was beastie, too. Atlanta was very beastie. Yep, make sure I don't miss no dates. Atlanta was beastie. We had Nate, Imran, Rick, Keita, Vic, and Teacup Lou around. Shout out Teacup Lou. I love you, big bro. You didn't have to necessarily come from I'm Millennials 2 to Atlanta and pull up on the family and drop some gems, bro. That's special to me. And that's why you have me the way you have me, bro. I'll do anything for you, anything you need. because you just share that love. But yeah, we smashed Atlanta. Atlanta was dope, especially because Atlanta's kind of where we built the business when we started in Morehouse College. So it's like a little bit more personal. It's like that personal connection. And we gave them personal gems. The personal, the information was extremely personal to make sure they personally succeed. I feel like I'm saying personal a lot, but yeah, Atlanta was definitely personal. Rick came out there, he talked about listening, right? Especially for him. I love now that he's starting to talk. That talk, I've been talking about it a lot more around in certain events when I'm with Rick. But he was talking that talk about just listening and making sure that you take your success seriously. Then we passed it off to Imran next, I believe. Imran, you came out there, you gave them what they needed. I firmly believe, like, because I took notes. I always take notes when speakers are going. Imran, we could have stopped the event right there. I could have packed my bags. I could have went to Florida because you dead ass gave them everything they needed right there.
Peter, Nathan Samuel, Greg Ray, Mr. Tika, Rico, myself, right, this training is provided for you. So now you have to understand, okay, I have access to these trainings, right? I have access to these source of information, right? I like to say that this opportunity, how many of us have Telegram? Right, everybody. What if I told you that there was $1 million for you sitting in Telegram? Right, who would open it? I'm telling you that there's $1 million waiting for you in Telegram right now. The only thing is it's in the form of trainings, right? And it's in the form of trade send. So once you understand that you have a multi-million dollar opportunity in front of you in the form of Telegram, trade set. What I mean by that is, okay, you have to plug into these trainings, right? You have to plug into the trade set. This is $1 million for you that I'm telling you about. But a lot of the times that we don't realize that we have $1 million sitting in our trainings.
You talked about risk management, you talked about listening, you talked about a whole bunch of stuff.
You don't hit Chamber without results. So every single person that is up here today going to sleep has had results. And results doesn't mean $1,000 a day, right? But a lot of us come in this opportunity sometimes and say, okay, I have to make $1,000 a day. That's the only people, that's the only person, that's the only way somebody's gonna believe. How many of us feel like that? Right? Truth be told, started out $5 bids. Started out with $15 weeks. Right? I started out withdrawing a $20 day. Right? But now that's results, right? If I can fund a $50 account and turn 50 to 70, that's results.
But Imran, that was dope, man. I see you. I told you this in Atlanta when we were in Raker, but you have great guidance and you have a great position. And you're not playing with it. Like, you're not playing with it. You're not taking any moments for granted. You're being extremely humble and you're being truthful with the light that you have. So that was dope, Imran. That was really, really dope. Next, after Imran, we had Vic.
We had a great week because I did all of these things right every single day. I joined a business, they had been P2 like 10 months, probably 11 months specifically, had been a while when I joined, right? And then in what, 9 months, I see a BT go from C10 to C250. You literally don't know. You have to be prepared. You have to be prepared for when that next super spike happens.
Vic, man. My Vic is like my tank. Vic is like, I'm walking down the street, I got a tank behind me. Ready to dump off anybody. That's Vic. And I'm excited for these next few dates. I'm excited for Florida today. We actually about to go do informational today. Then we have All Roads Blueprint training tomorrow. Then we're going to Charlotte, me and Vic. Then we're going to Memphis, me and Vic. But in Atlanta, bro, especially because you're from Atlanta, you did your thing, bro. You put on, you know what I mean, your quarterback, got in your quarterback position and you ran the play. And just watch you talk and watch you just be truthful and be transparent to the people. I know a lot of people's success are going to is going to elevate through the roof, because they're going to learn from a lot of the mistakes we made early on. And seeing you be that transparent, it just shows that you're growing, and it also shows that you're really having. A lot of people aren't transparent because they're not really getting results from this opportunity, but I mean, we always know you got results, big bro. We always knew that, but just watching you be transparent and just watching you grow, watching how you did 2019, how you're starting out the first quarter of 2020, it's amazing. And I love you, bro. I literally don't know where I would be if I didn't meet you, bro. If we didn't cross paths. And I'm forever grateful for you. Yeah, it was dope. I was getting the chills. I know we talked about the chills earlier in the doc, but I was getting the chills watching you speak, bro. And with your champion jersey, like, I gotta get one. I definitely gotta get one, bro. You're special. Keep putting on for the family, keep putting on for your people, and just remember all the trainings and remember all the blessings that we've received along the way. After that, we had Marquita Jackson.
The fact that not everyone knows how to connect mentally and actually put in work, not everyone's gonna make it. Ready to sweat, so I have to be ready to be structured enough to make it up here. Sometimes if you really like that, you'll lunch, right? Sometimes if you really like that, you'll sprint. That's all we have now. I mean, there's a lot of recent chairmen that have seen what the past chairman have done, right? They took the climb, right, up the stairs. And now they're seeing how easy it was, obviously very simple in their eyes, that how simple it was to just go up the stairs. Now they're sprinting, they're running up the stairs. They're really hitting the chairman within months. Jalen Dox, 3 months.
The number one shooter. I don't have to talk about you too much, bro. I don't have to talk about you too much because you're really my shooter.
You got to go back and realize, okay, what was working for me, how I got these individuals to join my business, and how did I lose it? Okay, how was I up $10 on this trade, but I wasn't up $10 on this trade? Figure it out. Ask questions. You guys got good. In 2018, we didn't have no chairman to leverage. Y'all got lineups. Line up, man. We didn't have this. We weren't connected. What? Cole, come right here. What?
I really love you. Shout out to you for being the number one chairwoman. Well, there's a few number one chairwomen. I don't want anybody to take offense to that. But Marquita, you came through, you did what you needed to do. And Atlanta's doing what it needs to do as well, especially since you're an Atlanta native. It was beautiful, similar to Vic, to see you come through and be that transparent with the people. That's why I love this tour, bro. It's like, yo, we're dropping the fluff, all of the fluff that, you know, kind of was thought about as it pertains to this opportunity. It's kind of getting the leaders, us especially, us as leaders, we're kicking that fluff off and letting you know, bro, this is what it takes. This is what we've been through. Don't think it was always this sweet. Right? Don't think that because you're seeing us on the 15th floor, don't think that we didn't have to take the stairs there. All right? And we're in these events now, we're kind of telling you, all right, this is how it was when we were on floor 6 and we were taking the stairs. And it might not have been no power, no heat. We might have been freezing, but we made our way up. It's just an analogy. Obviously, that's not like reality, but it is reality. But for real, Keita, I love the fact that you were that transparent and you were real with the people. Like, you one took it. Like, you just one taking everything. Vic, too. No redos, you're not faking it. You did it in New York. I watched you do it in New York, but seeing you doing it in Atlanta with your people was special. It was really, really special. And then we seen you with the drip out too, doing your thing or whatever. That was dope. And after Keita, we had Ray Rice.
That's the part of it. You have to make sure that you're leaving that stuff behind and that you're growing on a daily basis. Actually applying this information and realize that. What if I told you that, right? You guys got access to Apple for the rest of the world, or access to the internet for the rest of the world, right? You guys had access to Apple before the iPhone dropped, right? You got access to the internet for computers working, right? You'd be super excited about the opportunity, right? Even though nobody else understands it, that's how you have to realize that's what this is. It's gonna go over everything.
Ray Rice, bro, I love you, blood. I love you, blood. I miss you, bro. I dead ass miss you, bro. This shit be tough sometimes. Should be tough sometimes on the road, man. Shout out 1402. Long live the guys. 2020, 2021, we got something back. We reviving 1402. We gonna pull it back together. But Ray, I love you, bro. I don't even gotta say much. I call you, we handle business like we always do, and you do what you always do. You're a madman, blood. I love you. But yeah, Ray, I'm gonna see you soon, bro. Make sure you hold your head on the road. Make sure you know what I mean. Keep your composure. See 100 your body. See 500 your body. I know it's coming. Yeah, man. After Ray, Teacup Lou popped out.
So, trading, I'm a Chairman 50. You know what Chairman 50 is? Write that number down. What's Chairman 50? What's that amount? Write it down. Because I'm going to show you what commitment really is. Right? Now, I'm a Chairman 45. Write that down. On Gold Cup, I'm a Chairman 40. This is monthly, people. Write that down. Now, I'm the highest paid educator in the company, Chairman 10. How much is that a month? How much is that a month? Huh? Yeah. 50, 40, 25, and 10. How much is that a month? Huh? 125, and I'm still here. It's okay, I'm still pulled up. Making $125 a month, and I'm still here, sitting there, listening to everything that all these chairmen say. Because I'm committed to this. I'd rather be here than be bitching at home on Netflix. What is at my house that's better than this right here? Just because I might be making this money doesn't mean I can't learn something from my man Vic right here, right? From Rico, from Ray, from Nate, from Keita, to help my business. Because I'm only a Chairman 25, Nate's a Chairman 100. So, my mind, the way I think, I gotta catch up to Nate.
Shout out Teacup Blue, man. We getting the lamb soon, lamb sliding through Atlanta. We ordered it. It takes 6 months to come in. Shout out, you know what I mean? Gold Cup, teacup. So we got gold inside seats. Lamb on the way. But yeah, bro, I appreciate you for coming out. We're not even in business together. That's it. Most people think nowadays, most people be thinking that Teacup is my upline or I'm Teacup's upline. But me and LaSalle are not really, we're not in business together, but we own business together. We family. Some way down the line, we became family. I don't even know. And it's crazy because I remember the first time I met Lou, I was Chairman 25 and we was in a club in Houston, and he was flexing on me, bro. But to see us go from that to this now, continue to matriculate, I love you, bro. And I could see why you flexed on me, because if I'd have done what I did back then, you would have flexed on me right now again. So it's just brotherly love, man. Continue to check on me in the gym. Continue to be there for me. Continue to be that inspiration, because it is beautiful to watch you take care of your family, take care of me and Camilla. Shout out to guys, man. But yeah, we here. And you came in Atlanta and you blew it up. You blew it all the way up. You talked about commitment. I remember that. You talked about commitment. Just making sure that you're committed to the success, your success, right? Committed to the success, your success, as it pertains to your family and whatnot. And that was dope. That was dope. I love you for that. And after that, in Atlanta, we had me.
I'm looking around, I'm studying people, I'm watching people on their phones, I'm watching people comment on other people's Instagram stories, I'm watching people doze off, right? And all that shows are you're not humble enough or grateful enough. You're not even really being truthful with yourself. Because you came outside here today to listen to information and you didn't give it your 100% attention. You scroll down at the top of your paper, it's for your paper. My paper is gonna get done. Regardless, I'm gonna continue to travel the world and attach myself to other people's success. I don't care who listens or who doesn't. That's why I'm here. And you're
and you need to treat your wife with the same humbleness, the same gratefulness, and the same truthfulness. But literally, you know that you do. When they get on the training, you're not just getting on the training for whatever reasons. You also get on the trainings with the perspective of, okay, I'm grateful to even have Mariko Shmoney host the SB5 training for me. Right? Somebody who's made a lot of money using this product, he's doing it for me for free. It's the truth. Right? How many of you say, if you feel like, okay, at the very least, I'm gonna start making a conscious effort to be more humble, more grateful, and more truthful. Everybody's nation is ready, really, really high right now. This is the most important part. Remember I said, this is all the information that you get from the chairman speakers, that's like the chess box. That's the chess box, but this is the key. So none of the stuff you heard from me, can I curse? Right? None of the shit you heard from these guys will work for you if you don't apply these words. So when I say, okay, who's gonna work with this? We should all have our hands raised. My hand is raised high, higher than yours, because I know, okay, the more I continue to work on this, the more my goals and my, what I really live for is gonna happen. So how many of us feel as a collective we can work on this? Mine is still hot, no slack, no bet.
I'm
gonna tell you something. It's gonna work, it's obviously gonna work. You're gonna listen and apply it, and you're gonna do it over the next day, and the next day, and the next day. Let's say as it pertains to trading, right? Now your portfolio is growing. Okay, 30 days of consistent listening and applying, that's 30 days of results, right? Because the trainer, the educator have results, right? Now 60 days, now 90 days, now 365 days. Now you find yourself in a position where you're walking around, you're walking different, you're talking different. People are looking at you different because of the success black dude. The success black dude. Understand that this time last year, Ronaldo Perez, Platinum 2000. Nathan Samuel, Platinum 2000. Vic Hardison, Platinum 2000.
Not even in
unranked. Platinum 1000, this time last year. But imagine if you just listen for 365 days and apply. Right? I always use this analogy because it snaps people's head. People always wake up. Right? Imagine right now we all had a job application, right? From, let's say, Citibank. And Citibank told us that, hey, they said, Nate, for the next 365 days, if you listen and do exactly what I tell you to do, we'll sign you a contract or we'll sign you an offer where we're going to pay you about $10,000 a month. I don't know about you, but I'd have done that for free. You wouldn't have done that for free, be honest. You're fresh out of college, you're in your field, and someone tells you right now, a big bank tells you right now, or a financial institution, or an investment, whatever the case may be, tells you right now, for the next 365 days, if you listen to what we say, you do exactly what we'll say, we'll give you a $10,000 deal every month. And every month moving forward that, you're making a minimum of $10,000. Raise your hand if you would take that deal and work for free. Right? I'm successful.
I'm successful.
I am loving.
I
am grateful.
I am grateful.
I am truthful.
I'm humble.
Chairman 500, my body.
Came out there, lad, in it, and I just set it off. It's crazy because I was feeling a little tired. I've been a little tired. Just this whole road, I've took the road obviously toward crazy, but this was like the biggest tour I've took on so far with the family, and I've just been a little tired traveling. I've been going through some personal stuff, but I remember being tired. But then as soon as I got up, it's like I tell my chairman leaders all the time, like, you got to put the mask on. It's like I put the mask on and I just got in a bag, man. Because it's about your success. It's about the family success. And I realize that's not something you can play with. You can't be lackadaisical. You can't come in and out of somebody's success that they want for their life. That's just not fair. So I'm stuck in there. I'm in there. And when I went in Atlanta, I remember sitting back, put my notebook up after Lou spoke, and then I just got immediately a burst of energy. I started sweating like how I do, and I went through the blueprint training and I made sure the people of Atlanta knew what it took for them to be successful. And like I said, we started this in Atlanta, so I do have a lot of personal connections with people who've been this with me for 3 years. And more than ever now, it's important for me that they matriculate in this business, not because of money, not because I want to see them have any more money, but just because I know it's what they deserve. And I know it's what not only they deserve, their families deserve, and everybody watching their success, they deserve to see them matriculate. So I took that training very, very personal. It was dope. The energy when I came in was like around a 65. When I left, it was on 100 for sure.
Chairman 500, my body!
Chairman 500, my body!
Chairman 500, my body!
Chairman 500, my body!
I am successful.
I am successful.
I am abundant.
I am abundant.
I have a village.
I have a village.
I will be successful.
I will be successful.
Chairman, scream on three. 1, 2, 3.
We stood up on the table, did the chairman scream and all that. But yeah, Atlanta. Make sure you put that information to use. There was a lot of leaders in there. You had a lot of leaders. Genesis, Mari, Lex. I don't want to forget a lot. I don't want to forget any names. There's a lot of people. Shout out Ian Jack, special guest. He was in the building. Donovan Baptiste, special guest. He was in the building. Corinne, special guest, was in the building. There was a lot of shooters in the building who I knew for quite some time, man. I want y'all to make sure y'all put that information to use because it's super, super, super important. We're not just traveling. I'm not just traveling specifically to all of these cities, doing these events for free, putting my time out there because, you know, I want to look cool. I want the flyer. I'm doing a lot of these little things because I want everybody to win. I want every single person in this opportunity to win. I remember what it felt like to be a Platinum 50 and just needed to be at one of those events to hear that information. I remember when I was a Platinum 50 and Brandon Thompson came in town and he basically did a blueprint training in Bryce Thompson CDP apartment. You guys might never remember. You guys, some of y'all don't even know about that, right? But I was P150 and I remember Brandon Thompson giving that training. It was just like, it felt like, yo, it was me and like seven people in the room, eight people in the room, but it was like that personal connection. And then from there, that's when I really started to admire Brandon Thompson for just his work ethic and his desire to see other people win. And that's what we're doing on these tours, man. It was literally just duplicating the success that was done to us to everybody in the world, literally everybody in the world. And now we're in Florida. We have the informational today. Excuse me, blueprint training tomorrow. And then we out to Charlotte the next day, man. I'm not taking a day off. I love you. If you're watching this, I love you. And I want you to remember to continue to run. Continue to love. Continue to fight the pain with love. Continue to just be the best version of yourself. Right? It's going to get a lot better. Things are going to be, you're going to prosper a lot in life. Right? You're listening to the right people. You have the right guidance. You have the right mentorship. You have the right love around you. So you're going to get there. I promise you. You're going to get to whatever it is you truly want out of this life. Not only with this opportunity, this information, but this family is going to get you there. So make sure you take that dead serious. And I understand we all go through things. We all have problems. But your problems are no bigger than mine, and mine are no bigger than yours. Right? And at the very least, God gave us 24 hours to wake up today and kill it. So I'm about to get off these cameras, man. Get back from behind these chairs. This is one take, too. I'm not two taking. It's three taking. This is one take, one edit. Because it's from the heart. I'm about to get out, and I'm about to get back in and fail, man, because that's where I belong. I can't do this camera stuff for too long because I like the little things. I like to thrive in solitude. The big stages are cool. That's one thing I realized, too, I'm millennials, too. That was the most I've ever been edified, or most I've ever had people in one room say, Nathan, help me, Nathan, and it truly warmed my heart, and it truly made me realize that we have to stay in the field. We have to continue to do the little things. We have to continue to thrive in solitude. Take those moments where nobody's seeing you. Like, if you look around, literally nobody is here right now but me and Lloyd. We're in the middle of Orlando, Florida. We could be doing anything. Could be at doing literally anything, right? But it's just us. It's just us right now doing the little things where nobody can see, because that's really where the impact happens. That's really where the millions of dollars are made. So I challenge you, man, get out the spotlight. Go thrive in solitude today. If no one told you this, I love you, man. And don't quit on me, because I would never quit on you.